Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Design Career Awareness Webinar. Today is day four. My name is Muzna. I'm the INCO coordinator at Dodd School of Design. So we have already completed, on day one, we did fine arts. On day two, we did spatial design. Day three was fashion. And today is communication design. Specifically, we're going to discuss about graphic design today. So before we get into that session, I am going to quickly take you through two videos about Dodd School of Design and what our infrastructure is like. So I'm just going to go on mute and show you the video now.
Start your design journey at Chennai's first exclusive design college. Dodd School of Design aims to equip the students with real-world knowledge and practical experience in the industry of design. Choose from our various specialized courses such as fashion design, industrial design, interior design, communication design, and visual arts. With renowned professionals from the industry as faculty, every department is well-equipped with fully functional studios and workshops such as art studio, apparel lab, handworking carpentry space, and much more. State-of-the-art metal workshop, woodworking workshop, printing technology lab, chroma key room, garment construction lab, and pattern making lab to assist the students in their designs and projects. The institute offers various digital tools like computer and communication labs, sound design lab, recording lab for the students to explore their interests in any medium. Sophisticated 3D printing machinery, laser cutting machine are available to initiate the students into ideating and prototyping their designs. Find all the tools required to let your imagination become a reality at Dodd. All while having a fun campus life. With workshops and events happening frequently, we provide you with a platform to co-learn, collaborate, and synergize with both your batchmates and the veterans in the industry. Let's appreciate the history of design and learn from the pioneers. Design and technology are the future of innovation. Join the design revolution at Dodd.
So that was just a quick sneak peek into what the campus looks like. Unfortunately, during the pandemic, we cannot invite you on campus, welcome you on campus to show you how it is. So I'll just tell you what is the agenda for the day. First, we will be having our academic speaker, Ms. Dhani Shah, who will be taking you through what is communication design like at Dodd, followed by Mr. Basan Joshua, who is our industry speaker for the day, and he'll be taking you through the career side of design and how it is to be a communication designer outside in the big bag world. So and then we will open up to the Q&A session. So you can feel free to start writing your questions right away on the chat, and we will be addressing all those questions towards the end. So Dhani, the stage is all yours. I'm going on mute now.
Thank you, Muzna. Hi, everybody. I'm Dhwani. I'm a graphic designer and illustrator from Bombay. I did my bachelor's in applied art and I did my master's in graphic design. And since then, I've dabbled in different areas of design and within the field of communication design. And so I have done a bit of packaging design. I've done a bit of signage and branding. But my core area of focus and interest lies in illustration and book design. And I'm really happy to, you know, have all of you here. And I'm so happy you are considering a potential career in design and you are trying to explore your options. So just like you, a couple of years back when I just finished my school, I realized that I enjoyed drawing and painting much more than other things. And I decided to step into art college and explore a potential career in that. So during that time, I thought that, okay, drawing is the only skill that is required. But only much later, while being in the part of the college and the design industry, I realized it is a much, much wider world. And there are a lot of associated skills that actually make a designer. And there are some very specific things you will need to learn to become a successful communication designer. So the program at Dot School of Design is done exactly for that, to equip you with all those skills, right? So drawing and painting, largely image making, that is something you will definitely need. And that is something you already have some kind of affinity towards. But you will be improving on that. And alongside that, you will be learning a lot of other things. So when you say communication design, what does that mean? So communication is an integral part of everything we do. Like, it comes very naturally to us humans. So, like, you know, even if you are telling about your day to your friend or your, you know, sibling in the end of the day, like, okay, you know, this is how my day went. Or if you are gossiping amongst friends, anything that you do, like, we are always communicating with each other. But when it comes to professional communication, you are, you know, designing messages, you are crafting communication for other people. So all the other industries in the world, for them, whether it is a pharmaceutical industry or, like, you know, any industry that's there, any industry out there, they all depend on communication design for their own marketing and internal communication purpose. So we are basically, you know, there, like, we are present in almost all areas of the industry in some way or the other. And so when I say crafting messages, what do I mean? So there is content, there is form, and then there is delivery. So content is stories, like, what are you trying to say? So a lot of the program is designed to help you design better content, develop better content, like, how can you creatively say things? Then form is what you are saying, what shape will that take? Like, the same thing that you have, the same thought can take different forms. So we will teach you different mediums and different formats that your messages can take. And then how will that reach the people out there? So how will you deliver your messages? So basically what we are going to do is equip you with creative thinking skills, but also technical abilities so that you can tell great stories and it can take whatever form. And when we are speaking about form, that is ever evolving. So we can start with something as basic and, like, you know, so primal, like the old cave paintings. So that was, like, you know, the initial signs of when humans started communicating. And right now we are, like, you know, at the stage where everything is digital and social media is a very, very big part of our lives. But in between that, so many things happened. Like, there was the book form that evolved, there was, like, radio, there was TV, there are animation, films, all these mediums are there. So, you know, when you enroll for a communication design program, you learn all of the nuances of these different mediums in detail. So you might have, you know, interest or affinity towards any one medium. Like, you might be particularly interested in animation or film or specifically graphic design. But you still need to understand the power and, you know, the nature of each of these mediums, because sometimes a certain medium might suit your content better. So when you dabble in each one of these categories, you will start understanding the nuances behind it and you will become a better judge of what medium to use to the best of your abilities, right? And so the first year at DOT, it is largely dedicated to the fundamentals of design. So you learn design elements, like, what are the basic design elements? They are, like, you know, it's like your toolkit, like the basic things you use to craft your messages. Then what are design principles? Like, what are the guiding principles that make design work? And then you also learn things like visual, the science behind visual perception. So what you are designing, how is it being received by others, what is the impact it is having on others, then, you know, basic things like color and composition. So all these are like building blocks which is like a very, very necessary foundation that will strengthen your basics so that whatever you do will be like rock solid. It will have like a certain, you'll be able to articulate better why you chose a certain thing. So a lot of times right now, whatever we are drawing, it's more intuitive, like, you know, I felt this was right. But once you start learning design and you start understanding the things behind it, like, you know, things like, okay, why rhythm is there, why balance is there, why hierarchy is there, things like this, then you start, you will be able to better articulate why a certain piece of design works and a certain piece of design doesn't work. So, you know, why is this a good poster and why this poster is not very effective? So it's not no longer a trial and error thing. Like once you have all the secrets, then you can be more like, you know, clear about why you are doing certain things. And you will also understand why some things start failing and some things really work with others. So yeah, this is the foundation here. And then in the later years, you will approach all the subjects in much more detail. So like within film and video, you might learn more specific aspects of like how to handle the camera or how to like, you know, plan the narrative of the film. There are like the workflow of how a film is made. In photography also, there are so many different levels. So you will become familiar with the smaller aspects of photography. In graphic design, so that is, graphic design is more my area, so I'll be able to elaborate on that better. So graphic design is largely working with word and image. So illustration and typography. Illustration is images and typography are words. And the way you combine them in different ways, that helps you shape the visual culture. So, you know, everything you see around us, like when you walk out of your house, so there is graffiti on the streets, there are signages, then even within the house, like from the morning till you, like, you know, when you wake up till you go to bed, you are constantly bombarded with visual messages. So say, first you have the alarm clock on your phone nowadays, it's not a physical alarm clock anymore. So that is also an interface somebody has designed. Then if you're going to brush your teeth, then the toothpaste packaging itself is something somebody has consciously decided to design to attract you to pick a particular toothpaste. Like, you know, when you are in the supermarket, why did you pick this one up and not the other one up? So maybe it was the TV ad that really attracted you, or maybe it was the packaging that really attracted you. So all these things, somebody is consciously deciding and designing to attract your attention. Then, like, you know, you are having breakfast, then all the cereals, like every single thing. If you actually sit down and make a list from morning to night, you will realize how much visual design you are encountering on a daily basis. So if I have to now speak of very specific areas within graphic design, this would be subjects in the college that you will study, but this also translates to career opportunities once you get out. So there is something called branding. So branding is like, you know, the look and feel, the visual representation of a company. So that becomes identity design, logo design of a certain company or an organization. Then there is signage. So, you know, when you go to malls or theaters, or if you go to certain parks, there are systems which guide you, like, you know, where you are and where you need to go. So that also becomes part of graphic design. Then there is something like, you know, you design spaces and environment. So when you go to museums or when you attend exhibitions, again, there is somebody consciously deciding, you know, what will go where, what will you read first, what will you see next. So all of that. Then there is publication design, which is designing books. So that could become magazines, it could become newspapers, it could become even annual reports, brochures, catalogs, those kind of things. Then there is packaging design. So packaging in itself is a huge industry. Like, you could focus just on FMCG products, like, you know, food products or like anything you find in the grocery stores, all of that. Then there is UI and UX design, which is interface design. So all the apps you are using, all the websites you are using. So that itself is a very, very popular field in the recent years that has lots of career opportunities. So whatever you do within like communication or graphic design, It is a very vast field and it is a very diverse field. And what is interesting about graphic design is it lets you be who you are. So for example, if you are somebody who likes to work in big teams, so there are jobs which will suit you in that sense. Like you can work with great teams. If you are somebody who prefers to work in smaller teams, then that is also something you can join firms with, you know, very, very small, close-knit group of people and mentors. And you can, of course, design your own roles also. So there are certain jobs that are not already up there, but you can start making those roles available for you. And again, like while you are studying at DOT, even though you choose communication design or graphic design, there are all these other departments around you. So say as a graphic designer, there is a textile designer in my batch who's like my friend, and I'm very good at making patterns and she's very good at weaving. Then somehow, like, you know, in that multidisciplinary environment, better collaborative ideas emerge. So you could take your illustrations and she could take her skills and you can bring something together. Or say you are very good at typography. You really like working with letters and scripts. And there is a friend of yours who is a furniture designer. And you both are really obsessed with books. So perhaps, you know, you could put together and design a bookshelf which is made out of letters. So just the environment at DOT is very conducive to coming up with good ideas. And like we said, theory is one big part of design. Like often we think design is like just drawing, but history is very important. Like why certain things were there before and how it has evolved and how it will continue to change. So understanding the history is quite important. So the theory is an indispensable part of the course. At the same time, it is quite a bit of hands-on work. So it is not just like, you know, reading and by-hearting. So that is one habit we have to unlearn. Like it's not just mugging up things, but, you know, actually learning and then applying that learning in real life context. So when you are learning history, it is not just to remember certain things, but to see how you can start using it in your current designs, right? And also like the way you collaborate, that kind of changes. So when I was talking about multiple skills, so drawing is one skill, but also researching, like how good you are at researching, that is very, very important. Like everything you do is kind of linked to some kind of research. Like whether your idea, you have to test your ideas, right? So communication design is slightly different than say fine art, even though both of them have illustration or image making. So, you know, when you are doing fine art, it is more like personal expression. But when you are making an image for an audience, so communication design always has the target audience at the end. So whatever you are designing has to be understood by somebody else. So that is something we cannot disconnect. So whatever you are doing has to be tested. So whether it is actually getting communicated, whether it is actually getting across, because you might mean one thing, like you might use the color red to signify like passion or enthusiasm, and it might be interpreted as danger by somebody else. So, you know, actually learning how to use colors, how to use text, how to bring all of this together in the form of a book cover or a poster, anything like that. So all these small things you will, over the period of 4 years, you will start learning. And you can also keep changing your interests. So say for example, this is one field which lets you do your career in graphic design, but it also lets you dabble in other topics. So say personally, you are very interested in astronomy, then you know the kind of projects you take up might be geared towards that. Or if you are somebody who loves music, so maybe you could design a book on music or you could design an app on music. So it lets you be part of other worlds simultaneously. At the same time, you can't always choose the topic. So if I'm working as an illustrator for magazines, sometimes there will be an article on economics, right? So I may not be an economist, but I should still have the skills to be able to skim the article pick out key points and then understand how do I condense that whole idea in one visual, or what kind of word would be a good caption for something. So all of these things is equally part of graphic design. So creative thinking skills is one big core area, and the technical skills is other area. So the technical skills would be your painting skills, drawing skills, learning softwares, learning to use different mediums, and then presenting your work is another whole ball game, because you might do a lot of work, but as communication designers, you have to also learn to speak and articulate what you are doing. Because unless you are, a lot of times our work itself will speak for, you know, you. Like, you don't have to explain everything, but you still need the confidence to sell your ideas to others. So if you are designing certain logos, why do you think this logo is good for that company? If you are not convinced yourself, your client is not going to buy that. So even in the course, it's not just grading that, okay, you submit an assignment and you get graded like in school tests. We are constantly encouraged, you know, we have internal juries and we have external juries. So internal juries, you will have all your faculties and your classmates around you when you are presenting. So constantly you will be encouraged. Every assignment you have to present and talk about the process you did. The process is equally important as the output. So you start to learn to present your ideas better too. So yeah, I think I've been talking for a long time, but yeah, there's so much you can do at Dot School of Design, and I'll be so happy to see some of you join us. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jhani. That was extremely exhaustive and insightful, actually. I think a lot of us did not know how deep graphic design or communication design can go. So thank you so much for that. So now I'm going to quickly play like a video of what the students, current students of Dot, think of the environment at Dot and what their feedback has been about studying over here. So I'll just show a quick video and then we'll go into our industry speaker.
Hello everyone, this is Ashwin Ravichandran and I'm doing my bachelor's in communication design.
Hey everyone, I'm Akshara and I'm pursuing my bachelor's degree in communication design.
Hey guys, this is Aryan from Dot School of Design. I'm doing BDES interior design.
Hi friends, and this is Carolyn. I'm studying communication design from Dot School of Design.
I'm Krish Karna. I'm from Dot School of Design. I've chosen industrial designing.
I'm Vidya, doing BFA in Dot School of Design.
Hi, I'm Sahri Lekha. I'm fashion design student.
Hi, I'm Ovia from Dot School of Design, studying fashion designing.
Hi, I'm Nayanatara. I'm doing fashion design in Dot School of Design.
According to my understanding, designing is something where you could really, you know, grow in very high level than others.
And I also wanted to break the thinking of people that design is only related to fashion design or graphic design.
Right now, I feel so proud because, like, if I draw something, I can explain why I did a particular line.
I want to be creative and implement my ideas which I have.
And my experience until today has been really great.
Here in this field, we unlearn, we learn, we grow and we develop on what we do.
I've had most of my classes online, but unlike how people say that you cannot learn in online classes, that isn't true for us.
One would be satisfied only when he is happy with the work he does.
This is how we did, this is what we did in online classes.
We have things like we display our work and we talk and it's like an exhibition.
If online classes are this interesting, what about the offline classes?
The faculty is very friendly and easy to approach. It's been almost 6 months since I joined. I never regretted my decision.
After seeing the campus, I was very impressed on the infrastructure facilities and the ambience of the campus and getting that work experience when I'm studying itself.
My ultimate aim is to change or impact, create impact in design world with my own designing.
I thought, why shouldn't I take design as my career throughout my life? I decided to start my journey from Dot School of Design. So my journey has been began successfully and going on well, and I hope it will lead to my career path successfully.
experience in Dart School was really nice, and I'm looking forward to learn more from this college.
And the credit goes to Dart School of Design for creating an environment for us to learn, improve, and improvise.
And I'm so happy to be a part of Dart School of Design.
That is why I have been chosen design in Dart School of Design. Thank you.
Okay, so that was again a look into what our current students think about the campus. Now let me welcome Mr. Vasant Joshua. He's the co-founder of Find Creative Avenues in Mumbai. And now he's going to take you through what it is like to have a career path in communication design. Vasant, I've pinned her.
Hi guys, good evening. Can you guys hear me?
Yes, all good.
Just gonna present something. Can you guys see my screen?
One second, I've pinned you, so I'll have to take that view off. One second.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you guys. I think Dhwani made my job very easy. I think she went in detail about how design is always a part of your life, right? From you getting up and, you know, there's a lot of intervention where design is a part of your life. I just want to make it a little more light. I want to probably talk about, you know, where I'm from. I want to show you some of the work that I've done in the past few years and what you can expect out of a career from design, you know. So I'm quickly going to dive into my presentation. Not so much of a presentation, but yeah. Hello, my name is Vasant Joshua. People call me Josh. Easy to remember. Who am I? Like, you know, that's a typical question that I constantly keep asking myself. You know, right now I'm a design strategist and a founder. I'm from Chennai. I'm a Chennai boy. So all the stuff that, you know, I've learned from my hometown, I try to put it in my job, be it culture, language, food, anything for that matter. I love shoes. You know, one of the first inspirations that I, you know, which actually got me into design. So if I'm in the airport, if somebody's wearing a beautiful shoe, I'll be, you know, running towards them and asking them, where did you buy it? And, you know, I'll start a conversation. I just want to rewind a little bit about, 16 odd years. I'm not going to take too much time, but I'm going to quickly tell you, you know, where I started. In fact, me and Muzna almost started our careers together. You know, it's great to be a part of this session now. So I worked in three different cities. You know, I studied in Madras Christian College. I did visual communication. In the early second year itself, I was a little interested in advertising. I was very curious, so I started doing a lot of internships. So I went to Lintas. I worked in Lintas for a couple of years after college. Then, which gradually moved me from, you know, from Chennai to Bangalore to Bombay. You know, when it comes to design, communication design, right? Like how Dhwani was talking about, there are different things that are thrown at you, and you pick and choose what you want. And so advertising design and communication design really spoke to me. I said, okay, let me like see what I can do with that. So this is one of the first pieces of work that I done when I was in my first job, which actually got me a lot of credit. It won a can, so I got a huge fat salary because of that. And you know, it's a simple thing that I used, you know, that I saw somewhere in the streets. You know, when I used to go for my festivals back at home in the village. So I saw something which is interesting where people used to do. So I designed a logo where the yoga whole typeface is written with the people doing yoga itself, and then, you know, them doing yoga in front of that. So that got a lot of attention, and you know, it actually put me in the map, so to say. Then this is something that, you know, which is a very, very interesting project that I've done with Mudra. So we were shifting office. So there were a lot of visiting cards with the old address. So they were all thrown out in the dustbin. So I was thinking what to do with it, right? How do we use it? I didn't want to throw all of it into the dustbin. So I thought, okay, what can we do? So I kind of sat and made these small, interesting, objects out of the visiting cards. So I made all of them and then sent it to all our clients and said, see, listen, this is our old visiting card. So we're moving offices. Why don't you keep that on your desk? So whenever you look at this piece of work, you know that we've moved offices and we are in a new place. So which was an interesting piece of work that I done for Mudra. So I thought I'll share with you. This is a piece that I done in 2012. It was a competition piece. This was for Young Can Lion in 2012. The brief was very simple. They told us, how can you tell people not to talk on the phone while driving? This is not a very beautiful looking piece, but the idea is so great. You know, it actually won me the Young Can Lion in 2012. So I won the Young Can Lion in 2012 with that piece. After I went to Cannes, there's another competition that is there where a lot of people from the world, come together and participate. I actually lost that contest and I was very, detached from, what I was doing, and I was in a different mind space. So what actually, was interesting is the guy you see is Piyush Pandey, is one of the greatest creative minds. He was there in the festival. He actually called me and said, Josh, don't worry. I know that you're feeling bad, you're feeling sad, you're very, you're getting cynical and all that. But actually failure is a really, really, really a good learning step for you to move to the next level. So I think that was a turning point for me in my career, to see a failure, as a stepping stone for any designer, after that, I kind of used my skills and whatever I learned into a different form, like what Dwayne was talking about. So I used, a graphic and said, can I build something, from there? So I built this, a Red Bull Soapbox Race car, which actually got a lot of PR attention. Suddenly, my friends were talking about it and their friends were talking about it, and we got featured in the paper as well. So, so this is day-to-day life. Like, this is how, this is work. Right? Doesn't this look fun? Instead of sitting in front of a desk and typing numbers, I think design allows you to do such wonderful things, and you can face new challenges every day. In fact, for the past 16 years, I feel like, oh, it's 16 years. I can't believe that so much time has gone by. But it's fantastic that I get to do this kind of work day in and day out. So this is another piece of work that I've done. It's called Share My Dabba. I just designed a small sticker, that can go on a lunchbox where people in Mumbai, use dabba walas. They usually use them to deliver food. So we were working with this NGO. We thought, okay, it'll be an interesting idea to put a sticker on, the dabbas, where the lunch was not fully finished. So we thought, okay, instead of people eating four rotis or rice, they usually would not eat it, or they would like leave it. So we said, why don't we encourage people to share their food? So we gave out these stickers to offices, to put stickers on their dabbas so they can internally, share it with who are hungry. This is such a simple idea, right? But it got us a lot of attention. It got me a lot of, recognition. Shashi Tharoor, in fact, tweeted about it. So that was something interesting that happened in my career as well. So this happened, and then I kind of, immediately catapulted to, top 30 creative people in 2014. Then in 2015, LIA, chose me as top 60% in terms of how I can go and represent and run awards and be a part of a judging jury. So there were a lot happening in my career, and in fact, I was, you know, it was so quick that, you know, it's before I could think, you know, one good thing after the other started happening. I think it is very interesting that all this was happening to me was because I kind of understood what I loved, right? You know, I love design. You know, I wanted to do design. I wanted to do design communication. I kind of embraced it in day in and day out. Whatever I saw, whatever I did, I kind of used that. In 2016, this company called Sideways invited me to be, you know, head of design for them. So, you know, so it was a great opportunity for me to design something, you know, interesting. So I'd done the book cover for Amish Tripathi, Sita, the warrior of Mithila. So this is one, another piece that, you know, is nice. In 2017, I said, okay, I kind of was hitting a wall. I wanted a little more challenges. I wanted to be a part of a bigger ecosystem. So I said, okay, let the entrepreneur spirit in me, like, you know, burn brighter. So I started this company. It's called Fine Creative Avenues. It's a design studio. The philosophy that we follow is to create is to unite, like what Dhwani was talking about, collaboration, right? It's very, very important to collaborate with one another. And, you know, being a designer is almost like being a DJ, like, you know, putting the right songs, creating the right mood. It can be with fonts, it can be with images, it can be with photography, it can be with anything, you know, which was appropriate and right to create that piece of work. You know, so so I started this company and said, you know, everybody who is interested into you know, creation, right? And let's call all of them together and, you know, create a company. Why is a constant question that I keep asking myself. Why should somebody do it? Why should I do it? And why should anybody do it, right? And why should anybody take design, right? So that's an important question. And even I, you know, urge you guys to ask that time and again, because it'll only drive you, you know, forward and help you understand what you're doing better. The biggest difference between art and design design has two components, which is function and feeling. Art has only feeling. So when you understand design has two components, which is function and feeling, it's very, very easy. It's a cakewalk for you guys to, for you guys to play with it. So design is a very difficult word to define. So I'm just making it very, very simple. It's almost like a balloon. The words are swapped. It's without is without the air, and with is balloon with the air. It's that simple. There are three rules that, you know, I kind of follow in any work that I do. You should leave the ego out. If I don't know something, even at this stage, I've been in the industry for 16 years, but if I don't know a certain design, if I don't know a certain trend, if I don't know a certain things, I immediately, like, you know, ask somebody to help me out or teach me, or, you know, that's something that I, you know, do day in and day out. No question is stupid. You can ask, you know, any kind of question, and you know, it'll be very surprising to you that actually leads you into building an idea or a design or anything of that sort. The most important thing in my company that I keep is it has to be fun, right? You have to be, you know, involved in it. You know, you'll have to be engrossed in it for you to enjoy and do something. If it's not fun, if it's stressful, then obviously I think you're not in the right space. You need to pull back and rethink the whole strategy or the design that you've done. My company website is Fine Creative Avenues, finecreative.in. So you guys can check out some of the work we've done. Thank you. I think we can go to questions.
Thank you so much, Vasan. That was super, super insightful. Thanks for sharing all your work. Even I'm getting to see all your work right now, actually. So it was really nice. Now we're going to open the forum for questions. So on the chat window, Vani can also come in and put your thoughts through as well. Okay, can we have the recording of this? I'm sorry, I have to ask the team who's going to handle that. So I don't know if the recording will be available anywhere. But we'll keep you posted on that. I'll find out and I'll let you know maybe tomorrow. Any questions regarding? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Sai has put in the message. Yes, it will be uploaded on YouTube. Without NIFT exam, can I do BDES fashion designing in private college like DOT? DOT has their own examinations here called design aptitude test that you will need to take to get into a college over here, so into a course over here. So that happens very frequently, so you can just get onto the website and you can find out the details further. What are the basic skills that a student needs to know before joining the communication design course? Any of you can take that. Dhwani or Vasant, anyone?
I would urge Dhwani to like ask.
Yes.
I think some affinity towards working with text and images. But otherwise, just curiosity, willing to explore, willing to listen, because not all idea originates in your head. A lot of ideas are happening around you. You just need to tune in and, you know, listen to others. So like learning to see the world around you. So I think most of the things you will learn on the job, on campus, while doing. But yeah, just the willingness to explore and learn and realize that in design, there is no one right or wrong answer like math. So yeah, just being open is more than enough when you join the course. So yeah.
So when I started, visual design, I was like a backbencher. You know, I didn't win any awards. I was really bad at typography. I was really bad with, thing, but I had the attitude towards, you know, learning. I wanted to learn. I think that's very, very important. And I think if that's there, to see every day as a fresh start and learn something interesting, I think anybody can design, is what I would say.
Thanks, guys. So there's another question. It's a long question. I'll just quickly summarize it. So someone's daughter is interested in character design. So they want to know, is it a part of the communication design course over here? Or would we be touching that? Rani, maybe you can take that.
So, character design is very much part of communication design, but it's not. The course is not only dedicated to character design, it will be a small part of it. So when you say designing characters, it could become like, you know, characters for animation movies or for motion graphics or explainer videos. Your characters could also become mascots for, you know, certain branding and logo design projects. So although it is definitely a part of it, or it could also be like, you know, even if you are into UI UX, and you have to kind of plan what the app is like, you still need certain characters to build potential scenarios of potential users. So it will definitely be a part of the program, but it is not singularly focused on character design.
Yeah, right. Thanks for that. Is there a prerequisite for communication and graphic design at DOT? I mean, prerequisite would be like the skill set, you mean? I'm not very sure. Maybe they mean the skill set, like any drawing skills or something. Vani?
I'm not sure if they mean like for applying for the exam, if they need certain grades or certain, like you need to finish your 10th and 12th. Is that kind of a question or?
Okay, maybe you can just generally take only for the undergrad, what are the prerequisites required to get into dot communication design? From the skill set point of view as well.
So skills wise, you just like need to basically be able to draw and make stories, and like communication, whether it is English or any other language, you need some affinity towards languages. But I think in terms of applying for the course, that kind of prerequisites, the website might be able to guide you better. Like before you apply for the exam, there is a checklist of things you need to do. So yeah.
I would like to know if it's advisable for a UG graduate in commerce to continue PG diploma in graphic design. If so, what might be the skills needed? Again, so I think we've touched upon that, like at any point, whether it's UG, PG, as long as you have the inclination towards drawing or expression or communication, that should be okay. Okay. How far is interior design connected with communication design, or vice versa, or is there any connection between the two?
I think it is very, very related, because whatever you design also goes, your design gets applied in a certain space. So like I said, whether a poster you design, is it going to be on somebody's notice board, or is it going to be on a bus hoarding, or is it going to be in a museum space? So having a spatial understanding of where your design is going to be applied is really, really connected. But like I said, you can club graphic design with a lot of things. Now, if you are personally interested in the area of interior design, then you can find ways to connect the two in multiple ways. So environmental graphics and designing spaces is where one of these things overlap majorly.
Thank you, Dhwani. There are some questions with regards to, what is the difference between BDES and, BSc and things like that. If you guys want to take it, you can take it up, or else I can pass them on to the website where you can get your one-on-one counseling regards these questions, right? Like, because these are very technical questions with regards to the curriculum and all of that. So that you can probably go into the website. But if you have any specific questions with regards to the subject area, what kind of career or those kind of aspects, you can ask later. So for other questions, I will just share the website details over here, so you can go in there, and there's a number mentioned over there, there are websites mentioned over there, you can have a look and get your questions answered there. Okay. BSc BDES. Okay. To get good placement for the students. So we are in our second year of functioning in BDES right now, and we already have the INCO, which is something that I'm connected with, already organized over here. So we are streamlining all your, not just the final placements, but also helping you with projects, because that's what is going to start off. You're going to start off with some projects, internship opportunities. All that will be streamlined as and when things happen. So that shouldn't be an area of concern right now. Okay, is there any particular skills needed for the DOT exam, for the design aptitude test? How will it be conducted? Dhwani, do you have an idea about that?
I don't have an elaborate idea on the, what all you require, so I think the website or the person who counsels people at DOT would be the best person to answer this. But if you want to understand more about the the program and the subjects within the program, I can help you.
Even internships, for that matter, I don't think it'll only be interns. There will be a project towards the end, which will be a more elaborate project, but there will be more internship opportunities throughout the different years. What are the kind of internship that will be provided at communication in communication design? So, or we can shift the question to what are the kind of internships that you will be doing during communication design course? Maybe that could be a way of
So that is again open-ended, right? So within the communication design program, you will be doing graphic design, you will be doing photography and film and video. So there are certain things you will be learning, like the basics of, but you know, by your second or third year, you will start realizing you are more inclined towards one particular thing. So if I find out that I like typography a lot, and within typography also I like type design a lot, then I might look for internship opportunities of working with a font designer in the industry. Whereas somebody else might be really interested in photography, and within photography, they might want to do, like, you know, food photography or tabletop photography, or somebody might be interested in documentary as a medium of films. So depending on what your key area of interest is, you then start finding out people who could potentially mentor you. So sometimes the students themselves try to find and identify those people. Sometimes the college will offer you certain connections and help you build a network, and then they can help you collaborate with those people. But there is no like fixed list of internships. It emerges based on your personal interests.
Right. So in the same year, you know, there could be students who would be taking photography versus some students might go for videography or something like that. Filming and all that. So after undergrad here, will a student be eligible for MDes? So this is a BDes course. So you will be, you know, reputed college is up to you when you will be getting in. But this is a BDes course, and you will be qualified to take up a MDes program in your post-grad. What will you be learning in the PG diploma in communication design?
Okay. So as far as I know, the BDes communication program is a mix of film and video photography and graphic design. But the PGE program is specifically focusing on graphic design only. So then that would be more of history of communication design, typography, image making, photography, motion graphics, packaging, signage, book design, those kinds of things. So video and photography will be a very small part of it. But the BDes program is much more extensive in that sense. It covers all the basics and it touches up on all the areas in much more detail. Whereas the PG is like a condensed program focusing specifically on graphic design.
Okay. There's like very specific questions into the, Would there be an entrance exam for students who do BDes at DOT? Yes, there will be an entrance exam. You will have to go through multiple rounds before you are accepted into the entrance, because just to check your aptitude towards design, towards creating something, that's about it. Okay. Since it's written sir, Vasant, it's probably directed at you. What is the career like for communication designers in terms of creative exploration as well as income point of view?
Okay. As far as the income bit is concerned, if you are a fantastic designer, right, you somewhere start from a lakh, you know, start from a lakh. So you have to be exceptionally good, should be top in the country, then that's the kind of money you get. But for anybody who's just starting off, it'll be somewhere around 20,000, 30,000 when you start off, you know, slowly understanding. It's very subjective, you know, it depends on industry to industry, what your skill set is, what you're bringing to the table, and what kind of company you're joining, all those things. In terms of exploration, What I would urge, you know, anybody who's, you know, joined Dutchman Design is internship. Apart from the college giving you an internship, I would urge you guys to, you know, go and see what all industries are there. Like, for instance, if I can, you know, help you out with different, you know, verticals when it comes to, let's say, there are design houses, there are advertising houses, there are photographers, in photographers. There are fashion photographers, there are food photography, there are, like, you know, there are 1,000 verticals which is there, which are plugged from design itself. So if you pick an interest, and then you will know, okay, where I can explore. So after 2 years, you figure out, okay, this is an area where that I've learned enough. I want to switch into a different vertical, you can. So that's how fluid the design vertical is. So I've spent 16 years in it and not been bored for a single day. So, you know, you could understand that, right? So that's what I think about exploration. And you can become an entrepreneur, you can start your own company, you can run your own design studio, you know. So that's what I've been doing. So you can do anything, man.
True. I mean, both of you, in fact, have taken it like in different directions and in two different places, actually. So that's really great. So we have an interesting question here, because Dot has newly started colleges is better than other colleges. It's a controversial question, but what we can say from our end is that since we are a new college, we will put in our 100%, and you can see the kind of you know, people that we have on board, and we've been having this whole session where you can see, you know, what kind of interaction we have with the industry already, and these are going to be your mentors in the future, and you will not only get like a great academic environment, but also that whole connect to what is really happening in the industry. So that is something that you will 100%, that is the aim that Dot School of Design definitely has and has been doing right now. So that is what I could say is the difference between any other college and Dot. That's where we come from. And if there would there be an entrance exam further on? I mean, again, a very, you know, technical question. You can go online, check all these details, rules and regulations of what are the qualifying exams and everything. You can have a look on the website. Okay, would one be taught basic skills of photography if one hasn't any prior experience?
Yes, definitely. We have faculties who are photographers and have a lot of experience in photography, and you will be taught the history of photography, the different kinds of cameras and technology that is available and evolving. You will also be learning the skills of how to take photographs, and yeah, it will be an in-depth subject which is part of the larger communication design. So you don't really need to come with any photographic skills. You will learn on ground, yeah.
Right, so we are nearing our end. So if you have any questions that have not been addressed so far, anything related to admission processes, the entrance exam, what are the criteria, you can go online. I'm again going to just copy paste the website details here, and you can go and have a look over there. There's even a phone number, you can call them up and book a one-on-one counseling session. So if you need any specific details, they will help you through it. Okay, I don't see any more questions coming. Okay, wait, one last one. Does one need to stay at hostel compulsory? No, it's not a residential course. If people are traveling from elsewhere, we have the hostel facility available over here. So you can opt for it if you need it. Yeah, so thank you so much, Vasant and Dhwani. Thank you so much for joining in and helping the students, you know, get the idea of what the industry is all about, and hopefully it'll be super useful to them to make an informed decision, which maybe we didn't have back then, but we somehow figured it out. So thank you so much for your time. Before we end the session, I am just going to put up the Instagram ID of our college, so you can go in there, and if you have any feedback with regards to this webinar, you can share your feedback over there. The story will have some questions put up, so you can go and share your insights over there. Thank you so much once again, guys, and
thank you guys.
I'll see you rest of the students tomorrow with our industrial design session at 5 o'clock. Thank you so much. Bye bye.
Thank you guys, have a nice day. Bye.